Hey, this is Dustin from Streamlabs. Today, I'm going to show you how to effectively identify and correct issues you may have with your alerts using Streamlabs OBS. If you've spent some time setting up your alerts and aren't able to get them working, we'll walk you through how to fix most of the common issues, step by step. Update software. First, we recommend trying the basics, making sure your software is up to date. Check your version of Streamlabs OBS to make sure it's the current version. You can see what version your software is in the upper left side of the application. If you're not sure, you can always get a fresh download to install from Streamlabs.com, where we always have the latest version to download. Relog into your account. Most Streamlabs tools use Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, or other APIs to pull info. Logging out of Streamlabs and then logging back in with the streaming service account that was causing issues will attempt to recreate the connection. In Streamlabs OBS, make sure you fully log out of the application by clicking the logout button on the upper right. Restart the application and log back in to reactivate your widgets. Re-add links. Sometimes, an alert issue may originate from the connection between your Streamlabs OBS and the website, or the cache within the source. If you're using Streamlabs OBS, try to clear the cache by removing your widget sources and re-adding them back in. The same can be done in OBS Studio or XSplit by removing browser sources and re-adding them. Relink account. It's possible that the connection between the two services has fully expired, which can happen after making major account changes. To disconnect your Streamlabs account from Twitch, log onto your Twitch account and go to Settings, Other Connections. From here, you can find Streamlabs and disconnect. Similarly, on YouTube, you can log on and go to Settings. Next, click on View or Change Account Settings. It'll take you to your Google account settings. Then under Sign In and Security, there's an option called Apps with Account Access. This shows you all the apps that can access your Google account. Click on Manage Apps, and then select Streamlabs. You'll then be able to remove its access from your account. On Mixer, the same option can be found by going to Account, then OAuth Apps. On Facebook, this is done under Settings, then Business Integrations. Once you've unlinked your account, make sure you're logged out of Streamlabs as well. Then log back in. You'll be asked to reconfirm the required permissions needed to use Streamlabs again. Firewall. Typically, your widgets will need to access the internet to receive new data. And if your firewall isn't set up properly, it could block them from doing so. To check this, open the control panel in Windows 7, and you can do this by going to Start. And in Windows 10, press the Win key. Click on Windows Defender Firewall. For some versions, you may need to click the System and Security section first. Click on Allow an app or feature through the Windows Defender Firewall to add permission. Scroll through to find Streamlabs OBS or another streaming software you may be using. If you are unable to find your streaming software on the list, click Allow another app. You might need to click Change Settings first if this is grayed out. From there, hit the Browse button and navigate to your streamingsoftware.exe file, which by default is located in Program Files, Streamlabs OBS. Select the .exe and click Add. IPv6. IPv6, or Internet Protocol Version 6, is a network layer protocol which allows communication and data transfers to take place over the network. You'll want to check your settings for this to make sure it's not interfering with this. And to do so, you'll need to go to your control panel by clicking Start in Windows 7 or pressing Win key in Windows 10. Click Network and Internet, then Network and Sharing Center. Next, click on your Used Connections Devices. This is commonly called Ethernet, but the name can differ. Click on Properties in the General tab of the Network Device Status, and scroll down to find Internet Protocol Version 6, TCP IPv6. Double-click it. Check Use the following DNS server addresses. Set the preferred and alternative DNS servers as shown here. Check Validate settings upon exit. click OK twice, click Close. As a last resort, you can also try unchecking Internet Protocol version 6, TCP IPv6 entirely. Reset API token. You can try to reset your API token, but please note that doing this will require you to update all of your Streamlabs widget URLs. First, remove all widgets from Streamlabs OBS or other streaming software by going to My Account, API Settings. From here, click the API Tokens tab, then refresh. Re-add your new widget links back into Streamlabs OBS Editor. Run a test alert to see if this worked. Reach out for help. If all else fails, Streamlabs has a support staff that wants to help. Reach out to us on Twitter or our Discord channel to get in touch with a team member who can help. Be sure to download Streamlabs OBS by visiting streamlabs.com and hop into our Discord server at discord.gg/stream for live community support. Check out the links in the description below.